Hi, everybody. I have some friends here, and one that you rarely get to see much of. So here's my snowflake, the one I call Fluffers all the time. Hi, you Fluffer Nut. Hi, you Fluffer Nut. And, of course, Spirit sounding off, and Spooky Doo, and I got Ladybug up here, and Chrissy went to hide with Daddy. That's what Chrissy does. But I got a Fluffer. Yeah, here's my Fluff. She's going to snip at him in a minute because he's in her face. Which anybody knows a lot about canines, two things that they don't like is nose-to-nose contact, unless it is their pack member, and even then it's kind of questionable at best. And the other thing is for a male to peck at them or sniff them in areas that they don't want sniffed. Yeah. But it's a Fluffer. It's a Fluff. Oh, goodness. Catch him. Catch him. Little nut. Okay. So, good morning, everybody. Yeah, now she comes back in frame. See how she is? Yeah, you know, my hair's all, because I literally woke up, ran, brushed through it, grabbed a little coffee, and I'm waiting for my coffee to brew. Yeah, it's crazy. It was a nice, quiet morning, and we have a bus stop across from the street, from our house. Drives my puppies crazy every single solitary morning. And what's silly about it is that it made sense when we moved here because the children that loaded onto the bus lived there in that complex. I don't live in a complex. I live in a house. Now, they don't. Because everybody moves and, you know how that works, guys. So, in my opinion, they need to move that bus stop before I lose my ever-loving mind. Because these are service animals, guys. And the ones that aren't full service animals yet, they are training for service animals. And this is interfering in their ability to learn. Chrissy, she's full-fledged. And believe me, you couldn't rattle her out of her duties for anything. She just, when she's focused on work, she's focused on work. And Snowy and Frosty were like that. They knew the signals, and there was also verbal commands that could be used. But it's all about, you know, things like leash tension and talking to them, and boy are they going to start barking, because I'm going to pause you, because that's the school bus. Okay, so the bus is gone. Now, what was weird, Spookers, what was weird is that all of a sudden we have a bicycle, what I think is Phoenix PD officer, could be neighborhood watch, but I doubt it, because our neighborhood watch guy is like old. I'm old. This guy's really old. And all he does is run around complaining about people with, if they have a weed in their yard. Really? Not the girl. So as you can see, I've also got, well, you can't see Ladybug and Snowflake up here, but you can see Big Old Spirit came to visit, too. He never visits. He, like, lives on this bed. I swear. He does. Spirit. Oh, big guy. This is my big chicken head. And I say chicken head because, A, he clucks. Don't even ask me, but if you listen carefully back in videos, you will hear him cluck. And B, this poor guy is the one with the severe anxiety disorder. I mean, we're talking extreme, chronic, acute. There, I can think of a number of words of how bad his anxiety disorder is, his separation anxiety. Poor pup. And then up here I have my pain in the butt. My husky Wawa Coon. There he is. There's my spooky doo. If you all can't tell, I have a Scooby-Doo issue, which I'm far from ashamed of. When I was a little girl, my grandpa and I, every Saturday morning, would watch Scooby-Doo. And that was my joy. That it was... Joyce had to go to work super early, and they would pick me up out of my bed and take me over to my grandparents next door, and I'd never wake up, and when I woke up, I'd be with my grandparents, and my grandpa would wake me up from my Scooby-Doo show. Yeah. And that was our special time. So, it's a really special, and anything Scooby-Doo is really special to me. That's especially old-school Scooby-Doo. It's one of those few childhood memories that I have that I'm glad I have. I'm really glad I have, because they were really cool. They were. So, I'm gonna go get some coffee, because girl needs her coffee. I'm not kidding you. Hi, Bugga. Okay, so I had to get my coffee. Yeah, I'm wearing these actual matching things that say love. I'm not a pink girl, so if you're going to send me stuff, please no pink. No pink. Purple and teal. Those are my colors. Purple, teal, even turquoise. Those are my colors. No pink. No. I'm not a pink person. I got a cool surprise. My husband got me a new pitcher for my ice because the bottom of mine broke. It's purple. You're like, pitcher for ice? Yeah, honey, when it's in a big group like that, it stays colder longer, doesn't melt as fast. It works for me. It works for me. So I'm going to move you guys while we chat so that I... Yep. Can lean. Oh, that's better. So I'm not so fuzzy. And sadly, I'm more close up. Ooh, ooh. Guys, this is what I look like most of the time. All right. This is not just a... I mean, it's worse right now because it's in the morning. But I love having makeup on. I love doing that. But... it's a cost issue, okay? It really is. Because of my skin sensitivities, it's a cost issue. So, whatever. My husband says I'm beautiful all the time. I think he needs new glasses. In fact, I know he needs new glasses, but you know how that goes. Not the computer, dude. Not the pooters. Cat. He's not giving me kisses. He's being rude. I don't know when he restarted it. But anyway, he's having one of those days. I went to grab my coffee and, wow. He decided, I'm going to take over mommy's spot. Yeah. I'm going to take over my mommy's spot because she thinks it's hers and I think it's mine. Yeah, that's kind of esky mentality is. They're just such a part of me, guys. I really don't know any other way to describe it, that my sanity hinges on them. When I had my three babies. You know what I mean by that. My original three. I'm going to adjust you because he's got his head on my laptop. Okay, you got it. Thank you. Yes, You can get off my computer. Him and Chrissy. And Spooky Duty switched to push everything. It's crazy. Anyway, my sanity kind of hinges on them because I'm alone a lot. Even if my husband or son are in the house, I'm alone a lot. I've told you before, and for those of you who are new, my husband's a day sleeper. I'm not. Not even close. Would you get your head up off the laptop? Dog. Big head. Big head. Yes. There's a reason I call you Big Head. But you've got a big head. Yes. A big, pretty head. I did not know he had hit the record button, by the way. Sorry about that. Okay, so I spend the majority of my time, like, all of my time. Ooh, cold nose back. Spooky. With canines. And it works for me. It works for me, guys. It keeps me sane. It keeps me level. When I'm hurting physically, they do their job. When I'm hurting emotionally, they're there. When I'm happy, it's usually because they did something goofy. Or if I wake up in a good mood, which happens a lot and then gets ruined. But when I wake up in a good mood like today, they're just happy in general. Yes. And then it continues until some idiot human screws it up. And I'm not saying that all humans are idiots. I'm saying that for some odd reason, human and idiot are synonymous around me. Sucks. I need some intelligent ones. Really? Got kisses? Yeah. I got kisses. So yeah, when I have days like today where I'm in a great mood and I'm just praying nothing really ruins it or takes it away from me or does anything odd. Cat's just weird. He's about to get in trouble with Snowflake. Spooky Doo is not spirit. No, I don't have an S thing. It was originally Snowy, Frosty, and Crystalline Winter. Okay. We call her Chrissy. Then life happened. Well, the end of life happened. And it became Chrissy and Ladybug. And then the loss of another life happened. And it became the planet, the universe, God, throwing souls at me that needed me as much as I was going to need them, and I didn't know it. And so it went in this order, and it's kind of comical because the names will not make any sense to you. So it went from Snowy, Frosty, and Chrissy to Snowy, Chrissy, and Ladybug, and then it went to Chrissy and Ladybug. And then it went Chrissy, Ladybug, Spooky Doo, Spirit, and Snowflake. The S's were not intentional. It's what their personalities. Spooky got Spooky Doo because he was born on Leap Day. And I love Halloween, and my favorite character is Scooby-Doo, you guessed it. So my husband added the Doo part. He wanted to name him Scooby-Doo. I'm like, does he look like he's going to be the size of a Great Dane? Because that is not a Great Dane. That is an Eskimo Chihuahua mix. What a mix. Ooh, energy. Ball of energy and craziness. Yes. And this one. Giant lap dog, chest dog, whatever you want. When he lays on you, oh my goodness, you know you've been laid on. It's like... And then he loves on you, and it's okay. It's spirit. Okay, so enough about the puppies, I guess. There's never enough about the puppies. Ever, because, like I said, they're my sanity, guys. They're my connection to coming out of my painful emotions and staying somewhat happy. My kids have their own lives, guys. They're all adults. And my grandson, well, things aren't going the way that my husband and I would like it to. Or any of my family other than my dingy daughter. I think she's doing the right thing, and I think, sadly, is going to find out that what she's done is irreparable. I pray I'm wrong. I pray I'm wrong. I wish, hope, and pray that I am wrong. I don't think I am. And sadly, I have really good instincts about these things. And that's why I don't trust most humans. It really is. Okay, sorry guys. I didn't even intend this video to be this long, but life occurs, right? Oh, I look so fluffy when I position like that. And I am fluffier than I've ever been in my life, but I'm not okay with it, and it's gotta go. Because it creates more pain for me and discomfort, and it makes me feel even worse about me. And this is bad enough to make me feel bad about myself. I think, honestly, if this were fixed, I can deal with the rest. I can deal with the rest. As far as my personal appearance, I'd be doing makeup, I'd be doing my hair, I'd be, you know, but it is what it is, guys. And I just accept it. I may whine and complain about it, but I know there's nothing that I can do about it at this point in my life, at this junction, at probably any junction at the rate I'm going. If that were the worst thing that had ever happened to me, okay, I could deal with that. But it's not. And we are not going into that today. I refuse. Good morning coffee for everybody. Grab your coffee, grab your tea, grab whatever it is you drink in the mornings. That was a mouthful. Thank you, Lord. And good morning, Bob. Okay, so for new subscribers, if you wonder who Bob is, I just elbowed Pookie right in the head by accident. Baba was my dad. He passed on. It'll be 9 years ago this June. But he made a promise to me that if it were at all possible, he would watch over me. And he would find some way to let me know he was there. So, because we had a tradition of every morning, even when I was not with him at the time, I would call him and we would have our morning coffee. And we'd talk for a minute or two. And before we said a word, we'd take a sip of our coffee and say good morning. So, yeah, that's my coping mechanism. That's my family tradition, and I thought it had continued with my youngest daughter, but apparently she's a little irritated with me. Oh well, get mad, you gotta get glad again sometime. And if you don't, well, I'm sorry to hear that, but I'm not going to change at my age for my kid. My 23-year-old kid. She's just a kid. She thinks she's a grown woman, but in truth and fact, in a lot of ways she is, in a lot she's not. Like, oh, girls. He got elbowed. Oh, I feel so bad. Luckily, he's got a really hard head. Hard head. Yes. So, we're going to try and have a good day today. I am. I'm going to watch a couple of videos. I refuse to watch anything sad.
Yes.
Because, you know what? I have enough sadness and difficulty in my life when it comes to my father-in-law and what he is driving my husband to emotionally. Yeah. Oh, okay, Wawa man. He's not a Chihuahua. He's half Chihuahua. That's why we call him an Eskiwawa, because he's half American Eskimo, half Chihuahua. Guys, I repeat myself a billion times in case I have new subscribers. You have no idea how tired I am of repeating myself. However, people don't tend to go back and watch the old videos. I do. If I find a new channel, I generally go back and start from the beginning and work my way up. Find out who I'm dealing with. You have sharp nails. Okay, get up there. Stay off my laptop, please. Okay, so, I don't know if I'm going to color. Probably, because for days and weeks I've been trying to color to calm my stress levels. Sadly, I need my husband to go and deal with his father today. Yeah. I don't see that working real well. He's kind of on strike. God knows I can't blame him. But I have to think about what we need to do for here. And that's the thing. I'm thinking about what covers our family's needs. You have to understand, our family includes 5 little furry souls that need food and water and electricity, and because it's getting hot here. Hot. Now, this week, thank you, Lord, for the reprieve. We're actually going to have one day that's only 83 degree high. Oh, I'm so excited. Folks, it's been in the 90s. We peaked at 100 last week. 101, actually. Up in the air, which means it was much warmer down here. My poor air conditioning ran ridiculously. Drove me crazy. Drove my electric bill crazy. But dual coated animals and heat do not mix. So that's not an option, guys. Not an option. And my husband and sweating don't mix. He does not like sweat. Hi, spirit. I'm guessing he has a tickle in his ear, an itchy ear. So, yeah, I'm going to try and color today, maybe read a little bit. But what I'm not going to do is deal with my father-in-law. I'm not going to deal with my kids that are being buttheads. My son's fine. But I'm just not going to deal with it. I'm not going to do it. Nope. No how. My oldest daughter's not being a butthead. Let me clarify that. With my kid, that's being a butthead. I need to have a day of being Amber, not Mom. And sometimes I forget that once they grew up, my name was allowed to change back? They don't think so, because they know if they call me by my first name. Ooh, no. But they're gone, guys. They're supposed to all be gone. They were all gone. I was happy. I had my house to myself with my puppies and my husband, and he just kind of does his thing, and I do my thing, and it worked. It worked. But it's kind of crazy right now. I don't know. Look. Puppy toes. You want toes? Guys, I'm going to go, and I'm going to play with that spooky doo. Play with that spooky doo. Yeah, because he wants to play. And he's only a year old, so he's got to play sometimes, huh? Smooches. So, I guess smooches to you. My prayers and thoughts are with you all, and I hope that everything is going great on your end of the world. You know, please like and subscribe, and please contact me once in a while. I love hearing from people. I do. I need to be hearing from people, because I'm losing my ever-loving mind without it. Yeah. And no, I don't have my grandson for a couple of weeks, and I don't know when I'm going to be willing to take him for a while. Because what I saw after he got back from his visit with the boo-boos, his week with them, I don't think I want to deal with it. I really don't. In fact, I know I don't. That's not a behavior I'm willing to deal with. But I do believe that he has speech delay, and I need to get him into the right doctor and get that tested for. We know his hearing is fine because it's been tested multiple times, so we're past that step. Now we need to go to a speech therapist and find out what's going on. We'll see. So, anyway, I hope you guys have a great day, and I hope everything on your homesteads is going great, and in your homes and cities and wherever it is you may live, I hope you have a wonderful day. I really do. I'm gonna hibernate.